Hi and welcome to cgboomer.com. This is Hans Erickson and today is day 14 of my work in progress of making my little short film which will eventually end up in my logo and web header. Today is the first part of making my laptop, which is what my record player is going to kind of morph into. But we have to get, so we're in the process of going ahead and making my props. So let's go ahead and start that modeling process. Now, one of the difficulties I'm having right now is when I went and modeled my original laptop, I couldn't find any royalty-free reference materials that I really, you know, that I could share. So what I've done for reference materials for the purpose of this tutorial is I've taken some pictures or some renders of my model, and I'm sharing those as my reference materials. But quite frankly, my original model, I modeled from, basically what I did is I went to different websites that sell computers, and you can do the same. You can go to HP or Dell or any of the major manufacturers and you can find plenty of reference materials there. But let's go ahead and get into front view and make sure I'm in orthographic view by hitting 5 on my numpad. I'm going to hit G and Z to move it up one unit on my Z-axis, and then I'm going to take my object and transform, and I'm going to go origin to 3D cursor to bring my origin down to the base there. Now, one thing is that this computer is going to be basically 15 inches wide, 10 inches deep, and about an inch and a half tall, which is about the size of most laptops or some laptops. It's kind of an approximation, but it'll serve quite well. So to get those dimensions in there, so everything is scaled correctly, if you go on your scene data here, and seeing that I'm going to be working in inches, I'm going to hit Imperial, and click Separate Units, and by hitting N on my numpad, you can see that right now, in inches and everything, I'm sitting at 2 yards, 6.7 inches in each direction. So if I just click on the X-axis and go 15 inches, on the Y-axis go 10 inches, and on the Z-axis go 1.5 inches, you can see that I've got the basic shape of my laptop. Now I'm going to go ahead and click out of that and go back to none, because my what I wanted to do there, it was just kind of get an approximation of what it is that I wanted as far as sizing goes. That is definitely a little bit on the small side, and I don't want to work in those smaller dimensions at this moment. So by just going to top view, I'm just going to size it up, let's say 8 times. And that should be just fine. Okay, next I'm going to go into edit view, and I'm going to add a loop and set it right in the center there. I'm going to grab these 4 vertices here, and I'm going to delete those vertices so that I have half a box. Go back into object view, go to my modifiers, and I'm going to add a mirror modifier. I'm going to allow clipping and enable editing in the edit cage, and there I have my basic shape back again. So everything I do on this side is going to be mirrored over on the other side, and it's going to allow for some good symmetry. All right, the other thing is I'm going to just kind of approximate, and I'm going to say the upper third of this box is going to be my lid or my my screen area, and the bottom two-thirds is going to be the base area of my laptop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go Control R to add some loops, and I'm just going to put in two loops to split it into three sections. I'm going to grab this bottom loop here, and I'm going to hit X and delete the edge loop. Now if I hit P to separate by selection, what I'm left with is two different objects now. They are referenced up here as cube and cube 001. Right now I'm in cube, and I'm just going to rename that as LT for laptop, and I'm just going to call it something really original. I'm just going to call it top. And this one here, I'm going to call this LT base. I bet you thought I was going to say bottom. Okay, going into object view, I'm going to take this top and I'm going to move it to a different layer. Then grabbing this, I'm going to shift into edit mode, and I'm going to grab these four vertices here, hit F to make a face. So that is a solid object now. Then going to my top here, I'm going to do the very same thing. I'm going to select it, grab these four vertices here, and hit F and make a face. So I've got my two different solid objects. The next thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to change the pivot point on this. If I go back into edit view, I'm going to grab this one vertex here. I'm going to hit Shift S, cursor to selected, and I'm going to get rid of that widget because I really find it very distracting. I'll go into object view and object transform origin to 3D cursor, because I want my origin to appear there. If I now go back where I'm looking at both objects by enabling both these layers, you can see that if I rotate, let me get right into side view here, if I rotate this now, my top will rotate just exactly the way that I want it to do. And it is rotating on the x-axis. If you look up here, you can see that it's rotating on the x-axis. And if I rotate it all the way up, you can see that it is basically at, I'd like it to go from 0 to minus 110. So if I go to my constraints and I add a constraint where it is limit rotation, I can lock out the X and Y, or excuse me, the Y and the Z, so that it doesn't rotate. I've limited the rotation to 0 and 0, and I can also do the same thing here by hitting these little lock buttons so that it won't rotate except on the X-axis. If I enable this here right now, it won't rotate at all. It's completely locked. But I can, the highest value would be 0 when it's completely shut, and the lowest value would be minus 110 degrees. So I'm just going to hit that. I'm going to hit minus 110, and now when I go to rotate this, it'll stop right at 110, won't go any further, and it won't flip any further than 0 on the other direction. So that is good. I'm going to hide my bottom now, or my top. I'm going to go into top view, and I think right now we need to take a look at some of my reference materials. If I go ahead and go into wireframe mode here, And you'll have to excuse the noise in the background. That's my 3-year-old granddaughter letting everybody know that she's alive and well. If I click background images and add an image, I'm going to set the view to top because I'm looking from the top. I can open. Let me go to where I need to be here. Go to day 14 in video files, textures, and you can see that I have a keyboard and a base, and we're going to go ahead and open up that base. And there we go. You can see that I need to do some sizing, and so let me take this here and let's go ahead and size it down. First of all, I'm going to run the opacity up just a tad so I can see it a little bit better. Let's go ahead and size that to fit my model of what I have. And I think right about there at 6.97 is going to be just about right. It's not too far. In fact, that'll seems to work okay. Might just jump up just a little bit. Let me let's go 6.98. No, I need to go the other direction. All right, that doesn't look too bad. That'll work. I'll be happy with that. Just so I've got something to kind of work off of. The first thing, if you can kind of see here from the profile just a little bit, is I've got this whole area raised a little bit, so when the top closes, it's got a lip to close on. So we're going to go ahead and add all of that in right now. And the way that we're going to do that is I'm going to add a couple loops in here. Control R. Well, let me get into edit mode. Control R. There we go. Get into edit mode. Control R. I've got that loop, and we're going to pull it right about to there. And then Control R. I'm going to add two loops in here. Kind of zoom in a little bit. And then S, and on the Y axis, I'm going to kind of size that. And what I'm shooting for is to kind of get this little block down here to look fairly square. So I've got that what I want. Now I'm going to hit Control R. I'm going to add in two more loops again, and I'm going to zoom down and then get S and Y again and move that to where the top of that raised area is, and then Control R this way, and again trying to keep that one little block there approximately square. That's about what I want. Now if I go into face mode, I can grab this face here and I can raise that up just ever so slightly by hitting G and Z, and holding my shift button down, I can kind of control it and raise it up. Let me go into solid view so I can see that a little bit better. And that actually looks just about what I want. Now, you know I'm going to need some edge loops in here. So let's go ahead and add those in right now. Get back into vertex mode here. And I'm going to go ahead and hit Control R. And I'm going to add a couple loops right there. Control R. Add a couple loops right in there. Control R. Add a couple loops right there. I'm going to need a loop close to this edge here. But actually, I'm going to need more than that. I'm going to need a loop for this area right here too. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit Control R and add two loops. That should be enough to add for both controls. And the same thing here, Control R. I'll add in two loops. Control R. Add in two loops. And that should do that. And I'm going to need some loops on top to keep this edge working well. So I'm going to hit Control R. And I'm just going to slide that over to right about there. Go 7 on my numpad. Control R, add two loops, and S and Y, and slide those over as well, like that. Okay, that should take care of that raised portion. Let's go ahead and add in some more edge loops here that I know I'm going to need here real shortly. So if I look here, I can see that I'm going to need some edge loops here to control this top and bottom here. So I'm going to hit Control R. I'm going to add two edge loops, and I'm going to S and Z, scale on the Z axis, and slide those close to the top and the bottom. And actually, I think that's about all I'm going to need right now. Let's go into here and let's go ahead and smooth this one time. And we might as well go ahead and add my multi-resolution modifier. And let's subdivide it at least one time. And that looks pretty good. I think one will work just fine. That's exactly what I want, so I'm going to be happy with that. Okay, going back into my top view and back into wireframe, you can see that I now have another raised portion here for where I'm setting my keyboard. So let's go ahead and add that in right now. So going Control R. I'm going to slide one to where the bottom would be, and then Control R one more time to where it would be at the top, and then Control R. Oops. Control R. And it's not adding. Hit 7. Control R. There I go. And I'll slide that to what I perceive as the bottom there. And Control R. The bottom of the raised portion, let me kind of zoom in and see if I got it about where I want. Yeah, that'll work there. This one can actually slide over G sub Y. Kind of slide that just a touch. Now I can go Control R. add in two loops, and I'm going to kind of zoom down and go S and Y and kind of make sure that that is kind of squared as well, just about right there. Okay, now if I go into face mode, grab that face there, I'm going to go back into object view so I can see a little bit better. I'm going to go G and Z, holding my shift down, and raise that up just a little bit. And that's got my keypad area raised. And again, you know I'm going to need some edge loops again. So let me go ahead and click that. And I'm going to hit Control R and slide that edge to right about there. Control R and pop in two edges there. Control R, pop in a couple edges there. Control R, pop in a couple edges there. I'm going to need one to control this flat area here, so Control R and slide that to right about there. And let's see, I'll need one right here to Control R and slide that over to there. And add another loop for to control that top, Control R, and slide that one over to right about there. And then Control R. I can add two loops this time, and S and Y, and slide those over to right about there. If I go into object mode, you can see how I've got that raised portion, and it looks fairly nice as well. Okay, I'm just trying to get the basic shapes in right now. So let me excuse the Skype there. Let me go back into wireframe. Whoops. Yeah, let me go back into wireframe. Now my next little area is this area here, is kind of like a little depressed area where the keypad, or where you emulate the mouse with a right and left click button, that is raised. This is depressed and these two are raised. So let me go ahead and work on these right now. So let's go Control R, and I'm going to slide that over to about there. This line right here looks as though it's going to work just fine to control the top flat part here. So I just need to add one down here. So Control R, and I'll slide that down to right about there. Control R, and I'll slide this over. I'm going to make this one right about here, which is a little different than the model, but, and then I'm going to add two loops, Control R here, oops, two, and S, oops, what do I got here? Something's kind of acting goofy on me. Let me Control Z. Alright, Control R. I'm going to slide this one up to about here. Oh, I know what I did wrong. Control Z. It's Control R twice. And then I want to S and Y. And I'll till that kind of squares out there. And that should work. Alright, going back into solid view and hitting face mode, I'm going to grab that area there. And I'm going to go G and Z, holding my shift button, and depress that slightly. Doesn't need to be a great deal, just slightly. And again, I'm going to need some control edges again. You know, that's almost a given. So let's go back into vertex, and I'm going to add two loops across here. Control R. There we go. Control R. Lots of little edge loops, which is just fine. Control R. Couple edge loops there. I'm going to need an edge loop to control here, here, and here, and here. So let's go ahead and add those in. Control R. And, well, it didn't. I'll hit 7 on my numpad here. Control R. There I go. And let's slide that over to right about there. Control R. And we'll slide that over to about there. I think I got plenty of edge loops right here. I don't need to add in any more. But I need to go Control R here, add in two edge loops, and then S on the Y axis. And Control R. And we'll slide that over. And let's take a look, and that worked just fine. I'm kind of happy with what we got so far. Going 7 on my, and then going back into wireframe, going into edit view, you can see now that I've just got to do my two little raised buttons. And I'm going to kind of disregard the model at this point, the reference material, because you can see I'm kind of running and overlapping a little bit. But seeing it's just a guide, I don't really need to use it so much. I just need to get two raised buttons in here. So let's go back into solid view. And I'm going to hit Control R, add a couple loops, and S, and X. Let's kind of slide those over. That'll be the bottom. Control R and two edge loops here. And we'll go S and Y. This again will be the flat part at the bottom. Control R. S and X. To right about there. Control R. Two loops. S and Y. And kind of keep that a little squared right in here. I think that's what I want. So let me hit. I'm going to grab those two there, and I'm going to go G and Z and raise those up as though they're like two little buttons to depress. And I think that's just about what I want, and I'm going to need some edge loops to kind of control all of that. If I went ahead in object mode, you'd see that they are raised, but they're looking a little funky, so let's define them a little better. And we're going to do that again with edge loops. So go Control R. I'm going to add two edge loops in there. Control R. Two edge loops here. Control R. Two edge loops there. And then on the top here, I'm going to go Control R, add two edge loops, and then S and Y, and slide those over to right about there. And then Control R, add two edge loops, and then S and X, and slide that over, to right about there. Tons and tons and tons of edge loops, but pretty much got our basic shape now. If you take a look, that is just about exactly what I want. The only other thing to do is I want to add kind of an indented line or in here, so let me come into here and I'm going to hit Control R and I'm going to slide this up to I think right about there. Let me see. G sub Z. I'm just going to move that up just a tad. Alright, Control R. I add another line and kind of move that to right about there. Control R. Take another line and add that to right about there. And I'm going to do this one more time for edge control. Control R. Grab that and move that up to right about there. And I'm going to grab this loop here and I'm just going to S and Shift Z to, so I'm only going in the X and the Y axis, and I'm going to scale that in. Now if I, you can see how I've got that like that indentation going in, which is about what I want. I want to sharpen it up a little bit, and the way that I can do that is if I go into front view here and zoom right in, I can sharpen that up by taking this line and and this line and go S and Z. I can kind of move that right in there. And then take this line and G and Z, slide that up to control that edge, and then Control R here to add another loop and slide that in right about there. Now if I slip back into edit view or into object view, you can see I got pretty precisely what I wanted. In fact, if I would subdivide that one more time, I think that sharpened it up pretty good. I'm going to hit Optimal Display. I may go ahead and delete that so I don't get 20 bazillion vertices in here, but for right now I'm going to leave that. The other thing that I've noticed is most laptops have the bottom kind of indented in a little bit. So let's go ahead and work on that now. first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this loop here, and I'm just going to kind of G sub Z, kind of move it up some. You'll see why here in just a second. That's exactly what I want. Now I'm going to, yeah, that's what I want. I don't think I moved it up too far. I'm going to grab all of this line here. And I'm going to move this on the x-axis. I'm going to go G and X, and I think probably about point, I think point O, starting to get into that axis there. I'm going to have some crossing, and I don't really like that. I'm going to grab all of them here, see if that'll work. S and S shift Z. And I think that worked. Let me, yeah, that worked. I just have to add some control, and I can do that by going control R. I can add a couple loops into there. Well, actually, let's go control R and slide one loop down, and then control R and slide one loop up. That will work, and then control R, take another loop and slide that down like that. Control that edge. Alright, going into object mode, that is pretty close to what I want. That'll work. I don't have any crossing of vertices. The only other thing that I need to do now is I want to make where my CD comes out. So if I go back into object view here, or edit view, well, let me see, I've got my basic shape here. I think what I really need to do at this point is to, I think I need to move my mirror modifier up on the stack. It won't allow me to, let me see, tab. At this point, I think I better save. I haven't saved in quite a while. Okay, that won't let me move it. I'm just going to apply my mirror modifier. That's what I wanted. Because what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to do a cutout on this side here, and if I left my mirror modifier on, I'm going to end up with a cutout on both sides, and I definitely don't want that. I've got my major stuff done here, so this is going to work. Shift into edit view. I'm going to go into face select. And I am going to grab this face right here. Make sure I got plenty of control lines going on here, and I do. So I think I'm going to be okay, and I'm going to go P. And I am going to then take and rename that part there as LT, oops, LT CD. And let me go H to hide. And for some reason this is not working well here. Let me find out why. That shouldn't be doing that. Let me go Control R. Let me add a edge loop in there and see if that helped. And it didn't. But I'm not really sure it's going to make that much of a difference. Control Z. Actually, it's not going to make a difference. Alt H to unhide. Oops. I'm going to go Alt H to unhide this. Grab that and go into Edit View. Okay, and I'm going to go into Wireframe. Go in top view, and I'm going to extrude that whole face in, just guessing, I'm going to say right about there. That'll work. And I'm now going to select this object here, and I'm going to move it to another layer. I'm going to take this object here, and I'm just going to add a few control loops in real quick. I'm going to go Control R, and S and Y. Kind of move that like yay. 7. S and Y. Move that like yay. Control R. S and X. Slide that over. Control R. Make a couple loops there. S and Z. And slide that up. And go into Object View. Solid. And that'll work. Okay. I'm not going to go into any more modeling of that right now. That'll be for another time. I'm going to take all of that. I'll need to fix this little deal here, and I just got to figure out what I have to do to square that back up. But I'll get on that. Actually, I think I already know. Let me try this. I think this is what I need to do. Let me grab this, this, this vertex here, and this vertex here. I think I got all the right vertexes. I do. And I'm going to extrude them on the x-axis, and I'm just going to move those in a little bit. I'm going to, yeah, that's going to do it. And I'm going to hide the CD portion here so I can see it. Go back to the base and Control R, add in two loops, S and X, okay, I'm getting there. Control R. Two loops. And S and Y. R, S, and Z, and slide those, and let's see if I got what I want now. Yep, that squared it out. Just had to think about it for a minute. Okay, let me Alt-H to unhide my little deal there, and with it selected, I want to do, I'm going to end it right here. I don't want to go much further. We're going to work on this here to keep it from, I'm going to be locking its location and definitely locking all rotation on it, so we're going to take care of that on the next tutorial. But right now we've got the base unit fairly well modeled. I'm going to go ahead on the next tutorial, lock that into place so that it doesn't go areas I don't want it to go, and we're going to start modeling the top. And then following that, we'll start working on the keys. So we're going to conclude right here. I want to thank you all for joining me on this work in progress on building my laptop. As always, this model will be available on my website at cgboomer.com, along with all of the reference materials and textures. Until then, I want to thank you for joining me, and we'll see you all later, and happy blending.